Hi Capricorn, this is Tracy from Northeast Tarot, and welcome to your weekly tarot forecast for the week of March 12th through the 18th. This is for Capricorn Sun, Capricorn Moon, and Capricorn Rising signs. So Capricorn, for this reading, I'm using the Hanson Roberts Tarot deck along with the Magical Times Empowerment cards. All right, and at the bottom of the deck, I have the Four of Swords. Very interesting. Taurus just had this in this position, so I'm not sure if there's like a Capricorn-Taurus connection here for some of you. But let's see here. The Four of Swords, you know, maybe some of you need a rest. Maybe you need some downtime if you've been working a lot. There could be some Capricorns that you are maybe going on vacay. The Four of Swords can obviously represent you spending some time alone. Some of you could be recharging. The Four of Swords is a healing energy. It's also a patient energy. So there could be some Capricorns that I'm reading for. Maybe the energy has felt, you know, on hold, or maybe a little stagnant, like not much has been happening. That can be, you know, a possibility for some of you. But the overall energy is the Magician, which, you know, the Magician I see as an empowering energy. He has everything he needs to be successful. You know, he's also incredibly creative, very, very resourceful. So with the Magician in this position, if you are a Capricorn where things have been on hold or maybe feeling a little stuck energy-wise, this could be you getting creative or being resourceful when it comes to kind of making some moves to move forward or to manifest, to start something new here. With the Devil, which the Devil does represent your sign, and we do have this King of Pentacles with the Devil here, so definitely Capricorn energy here. But with the Devil, it can also represent feeling stuck, feeling trapped. Maybe in like an unhealthy situation for some of you, a toxic relationship or an environment. Maybe something that's no longer serving you. Perhaps some of you maybe need to let something go. If that's the case, you know, there might be, even for a few of you, like a karmic cord that you have to cut. There could be some Capricorns that you are making a very important decision with Judgment and the King of Pentacles here. Some of you are looking at making a very important decision or a decision that's significant. So you could be receiving a decision, hearing a decision. For those of you that are making a decision, you're making the right decision. You will make the right decision here. You also could be, you know, really focused on the future here at this time and making those plans. If you were stuck, again, you know, getting creative, using the resources that you have available to you to free yourself, to move forward in some way. Again, with that Four of Swords, things could have felt stuck or stagnant. But I think that some of you are in the process of definitely moving forward, and you have, you know, a lot of possibilities in front of you. In particular, maybe this blessing, this new beginning here with the Ace of Cups that you've been working towards. The Ace of Cups is a beautiful blessing that's coming in for you, and it could be something that you're falling in love with, something that's going to make you incredibly happy. But we also have the Seven of Pentacles on top of it, which is something I think you've been working towards. For some of you, this is something you've been working very hard on. You've been planting those seeds. You've been putting a lot of maybe time and energy into this. But with this Four of Swords energy, you know, maybe feeling as though, you know, you haven't been making as much progress as you would like. But we have, you know, we have a couple of aces here with the Ace of Cups, which is, you know, a blessing that will make you incredibly happy, or one that you're going to fall in love with. And then we also have the Ace of Rods, which is an exciting new beginning. It can be one that you're passionate about, one that you're literally creating. So we have this exciting new beginning that is a blessing that's coming in for you. And, you know, with the Seven of Pentacles, some of you could be looking at, you know, maybe things that you've tried, You could be like evaluating a situation or looking at, you know, what's worked for you in the past, what hasn't worked for you. Some of you could be kind of re-strategizing here with this energy, especially if you feel stuck or you feel like, you know, energetically nothing has been happening or the progress has been very slow. With this combination, you know, I see you empowered. I see you, you know, definitely getting creative, being resourceful, and maybe going back to the drawing board, you know, figuring out what you're going to do next, how you're going to do it here, very focused on the future. And what's interesting is we have these sevens here. We have the Seven of Pentacles, the Seven of Rods. So maybe the number seven is significant for some of you. Something could have been going on for 7 weeks or 7 months, something like that. But also with this energy, Seven of Rods, it is a very fiery, passionate energy. This is someone who has a lot of inner strength, a lot of courage, a lot of passion. They're not going to back down. You know, this is someone that will fight for what it is that they want. It can even be a defensive energy. You know, I feel like some of you, you've worked very hard to manifest something here. It's something that you're very passionate about, something that will make you very happy. But again, maybe some of you feel stuck. So I think that some of you, this is you, you know, pushing on, pushing forward, not giving up when it comes to this, which is really good. You know, playing the cards that you have available to you. You know, that's what the magician does. You know, he's got a lot of resources, you know. So I think that some of you could be reaching out to some of those resources. Maybe you're networking, maybe you're talking to people. Some of you are getting creative. You're definitely using the tools that you have available to you when it comes to manifesting. So it's actually a really good spread. Even if, you know, you're a Capricorn that maybe you felt stuck or you weren't in the best situation, you're going to figure a way out of it. You are manifesting these new beginnings here. And if you need to make a decision, you will make the right decision. There will be a few of you watching this. It is a general reading. There's a few of you that will watch this that, you know, you need to cut some sort of karmic cord. So it could be like a karmic relationship. Some of you, you know, maybe need to cut some sort of karmic cord and move forward here. And when you do that, you will be rewarded with blessings that are going to come in. But let's pull you an additional guidance card, Capricorn. What else does Capricorn need to know? Please show me. Any sort of unhealthy behavior. It might not even be a relationship for some of you. It could be like with the devil, you know, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. It could be a behavior. It could be something that you're doing, in excess, something that's no longer serving you. You know, that's a possibility. Very nice. Wow, we actually have prosperity. Focus on the positive and more good will come. Give thanks for the blessings that you have and they will multiply. Prosperity begins in the mind. So beautiful. So focus on the positive and more positive or more good will come. So sometimes with the devil, for me, can represent fear. Even doing something in excess, you know, it could be even obsessing about a situation here. So, you know, focus on the positive, more good will come. Give thanks for the blessings and they will multiply. Prosperity begins in the mind. So staying focused, staying positive, not giving up, definitely. You know, and you do have a lot to be thankful for here. So, you know, maybe some of you, this is a new job. It's a possibility. If it is a new job that you're waiting on or a position that maybe you've been working towards, it could be one that you're, you know, going to fall in love with. You know, it could be a career, a position that you're going to really enjoy. So, you know, some of you, you have a lot to be thankful for already and you are moving towards more blessings. So, you know, this is wonderful, Capricorn. So I hope that you found this reading helpful. If you are not subscribed to me here on YouTube, please be sure to subscribe. If you are interested in having a private reading, please check out northeasttarot.com. I wish you a wonderful week.